What is up, guys? Welcome to the Elementary Experience. I'm so glad that you guys were able to tune in today. I can't wait to tell you about Philip and the Ethiopian eunuch in our story today. But before we do, we have to do one thing first. You probably can guess what it is. We're gonna worship. So why don't you stand up right where you are and sing this song, and I'll see you after. Hey guys, what's up? It's Abby here. I'm so glad that I could be here with you today. I have a question for you guys though. Have any of you guys ever played a team sport? I want you to shout out on the count of three what team sport you've played. Anything that is a team, soccer, volleyball, football, baseball. Ready? One, two, three, go. What? That's crazy. I heard so many different sports, but a really fun fact about me, I played volleyball for 9 years. 9 years is a lot. I'm almost 18, which is an adult. It's crazy. And I started playing when I was 9. That's a long time. But what we used to do for volleyball is we would have team tryouts. And team tryouts, we would go and we would see if we could make the team, basically. And the coach would evaluate and he would help pick new players, right? That kind of reminds me of like what the church is like. The only main difference is that God is our coach and he is in charge. He is in charge of the game plan. And us as players, we don't have to go to tryouts necessarily, but there are new players on the team. The only difference is that Jesus' team is never full. And on a sports team, there's only limited spots. But that kind of reminds me of this Bible story about a guy named Philip who listened to the Holy Spirit's guidance to recruit a new player onto Jesus' team. Come on, let me tell you about it. Okay, so let me just set the stage for you. This story starts with this guy named Philip, and an angel had come to Philip and told him to go to Jerusalem. So this guy, Philip, he's in Jerusalem because God told him to, right? And so he was around Jerusalem and he saw this Ethiopian eunuch. And an Ethiopian eunuch, it's kind of a type of servant. That's basically all you need to know. And this servant was a servant of Candace, which was the queen of Ethiopia. And so Philip was passing by and he saw this Ethiopian in his chariot. In his chariot, he was sitting reading out of Isaiah. And so this is where the story picks up for us. Philip listens to the Holy Spirit and goes over to him. So I want you to open your Bibles to Acts chapter 8, and I'm gonna open there with you. And I know this is a lot to read. We're gonna read through verses 29 through 31, okay? And if you don't have your Bible, that's okay. We're gonna put it on the screen for you to read. And the Spirit said to Philip, "Go over and join this chariot." So Philip ran to him and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and asked, "Do you understand what you're reading?" And he said, "How can I unless someone guides me?" And he invited Philip to come and sit with him. Okay, so Philip went over to this Ethiopian just because the Holy Spirit told him to. So let's keep reading and find out what happens next. I want you to read through 35 through 38. Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with the scripture, he told him the good news about Jesus. And as they were going along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "See, here is water. What prevents me from being baptized?" And he commanded the chariot to stop. And they both went down into the water, Philip and the eunuch, and he baptized him. Wow, that's so cool. As soon as the eunuch believed in Jesus and he heard the good news, Philip baptized him right there. And all of this happened just because Philip decided to listen and obey the Holy Spirit. Did you know that you can do that too? That we have the Holy Spirit and we can listen to him just like Philip did. Let me tell you about how we can use the Holy Spirit in our lives and how we can recruit new followers of Jesus into our family. So as soon as you accept Jesus, you get the Holy Spirit in your heart. You live with the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is basically a helper that was sent to us when Jesus died on the cross. We are able to be with Jesus in communion, and that's part of why Jesus died on the cross for us. So once we have the Holy Spirit, he is our helper through life. And that means that he can help us with have courage and be brave and help us spread the gospel to other people. So just like Philip, you can listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit and the tug on your heart to go tell other people about Jesus. I know it can be really hard sometimes, especially with people you don't know, or if it's just an uncomfortable situation. I get like that all the time. Sometimes I feel like the Holy Spirit is telling me to go tell someone about Jesus, but I just really don't want to. And that can be really hard sometimes, but that is the purpose of the Holy Spirit, to give us strength and courage and to help us spread the gospel, because we know Jesus is coming back one day and we need to spread it as much as we can to other people, because that's great news. And I know you guys know that. So, one thing I want you guys to do this week, I want you to talk about some ways that you can tell other people about Jesus with the help of the Holy Spirit. So when you go to your small groups, I want you to talk about specific ways this week with your small group leader that you can spread the gospel, okay? Bye guys, and I hope to see you again soon.
Hey Miss Abby, you got some spicy socks there?
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. It's Abby and her chili pepper socks. Glad they could make it today. With the Air Forces.